Hi, this is Anil and welcome to the video tutorial on Java programming. So this video tutorial is going to be the production of the YouTube channel Learning Lad, and the series of videos that we're going to make on Java programming is going to be for the beginners. So in this tutorial, we're going to learn about, you know, the Java's history and also features and about the Java buzzwords. So let's get started. So first of all, what is Java? Java is a powerful, versatile programming language for developing software running on mobile devices or desktop computers or servers. Now, the next thing is Java was developed by a team led by James Gosling at Sun Microsystems, and now that Sun Microsystems has been purchased by Oracle in 2010. The next thing is Java was originally called as Oak, and in 1995 the name was changed to Java. Alright, now we're gonna see some features of Java. So it's not possible for me to, you know, discuss all the features available in Java, but I'm gonna be stressing on some important features. So the first thing is Java is a high level programming language. So just like the languages like C and C++, Java is a higher level programming language, you know, which is easy to learn for the beginners, and also it allows us to write the programs very easily. The next thing is Java is a platform independent programming language. So it means that you're gonna write your program only once and you're gonna execute that code or that program in different platforms. For example, you know, let's say you have a program, and once you write that program in Java, you can execute that code in Windows platform, in Linux platform, and also in the Macintosh platform. So that's the beauty of Java. So you're gonna write the program only once and you're gonna execute that code anywhere at any time. The next thing is Java is a compiled and interpreted programming language. So this compilation and interpretation is used to convert your source code to a particular form, you know, which can be executed in your computer. So we're gonna be learning about this in the next tutorial in detail, but here just remember that, you know, Java is compiled and interpreted programming language. All right, now we're gonna see some Java buzzwords. So the first thing is Java is a simple programming language. Java was designed to be simple for the professional programmers to learn and use it efficiently. So if you have any experience in object-oriented programming languages such as C++ or PHP, then you're gonna find this Java very easy. And the next thing is Java is an object-oriented programming language, you know, which means we're gonna be using the classes, objects, and the features available in object-oriented approach in Java. And this Java is a completely object-oriented programming language. So everything is an object in Java. And the next thing is Java is a robust programming language. So using Java, you can write programs that can be executed reliably in variety of systems. So we can say that Java is one of the robust programming languages available today. And the next thing is Java is a multi-threaded programming language. Java was designed to meet the real-world requirements of creating interactive and networked programs. And to accomplish that, Java supports multi-threading, you know, which allows you to write programs that do multiple things or many things simultaneously. So if it is confusing, don't worry, we're gonna be learning all these things in detail in the upcoming tutorials. So just remember that, you know, Java allows you to do multiple things simultaneously. Alright, the next thing is architectural neutral. As I told you before, once you write the Java program, you guys can execute that code in any platform. You can execute that code in Windows, you can execute that code in Linux, or you guys can execute that code in Mac. So we can say that in Java, you're gonna write the program only once and you're gonna execute that code anywhere, anytime, and forever. And also, you don't need to worry about the operating system upgrades or, you know, the processor upgrades, etc., etc. And the next thing is Java is an interpreted and a programming language which provides high performance. In Java, we're going to be converting our source code to something called bytecodes, and then we're going to be interpret that bytecode using the JVM, you know, which is Java Virtual Machine, and we're going to be executing that bytecode. So Java is an interpreted programming language, and also the performance of Java is pretty good. And the next thing is Java is a distributed programming language. Java is designed for the distributed environment of the internet because it supports the TCP/IP protocol. Java also supports the remote method invocation or RMI, you know, which allows you guys to access or invoke the methods over a network. So if you guys don't understand all these things, don't worry, you know, we're going to be learning all these things in detail in the upcoming tutorials, and it's going to be clear, you know, once you start writing the course in Java. And the next and the last thing is that Java is a dynamic programming language. You can dynamically link code in a safe manner in Java. All right, the next thing or the last thing that we're going to see in this tutorial is about, you know, where Java can be used. So you can use this Java to develop the applications for desktop computers, and also you can use this Java to generate dynamic websites. You know, the dynamic websites are getting more popular and popular day by day in this modern era, and you guys can develop the dynamic websites by using JSP, you know, which is a part of Java. And then you guys can use this Java to develop the application for handheld devices. So if you guys know about the smartphones, and Android is one of the operating systems that can be installed or which is available with the smartphones, and you can develop the apps for the smartphones for the Android operating system by using the Java programming language. So this is it, guys. This is about the introduction to Java and also some information on Java programming language. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And you guys can follow us at Twitter at twitter.com/learningladedu, and also you guys can like our Facebook page at facebook.com/learninglad, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.